innovate to accelerate, the Navair workforce steps up to the challenge to find creative solutions to fleet problems. Plus, the F-35 program packs a powerful punch, stacking the deck with a dozen aircraft. And the advanced arresting gear remains the Navy's choice for its next generation recovery system. Welcome to this 2016 Year in Review edition of AIRWaves. I'm Michael Lauren Prue. We begin with big news for Naval Aviation. The Navy plans to move ahead with installation of advanced arresting gear on future Ford-class ships, including the John F. Kennedy and USS Enterprise. The decision came after rounds of successful testing on the AAG system at its land-based test site in Lakehurst, New Jersey, and aboard pre-commissioning unit Gerald R. Ford. By year's end, the program had completed more than 1,400 deadload arrestments and 351 test arrestments of the Super Hornet, the first aircraft type model series to undergo test on the system. The AAG team will continue multi-site test operations throughout 2017. For naval pilots hoping for a safer and less stressful way to land on a carrier at sea, your wish is granted. Magic Carpet is officially in the hands of the fleet. Maritime augmented guidance with integrated controls for carrier approach and recovery precision enabling technologies, or Magic Carpet, is a revolutionary improvement in aircraft carrier landings. It was delivered to Carrier Air Wing 11 in November, making its move from test to operational use. The highly augmented control system will ease pilot workload and make carrier landings more repeatable, which will improve safety, efficiency, and success rates in recovering fixed-wing aircraft aboard ship. The flight control algorithms for Magic Carpet were developed by Naval Air Systems Command and the Office of Naval Research. The F-35 program gave us a powerful look at the future of carrier operations at sea. The Marine Corps conducted a proof-of-concept demonstration on board USS America in November. This was the first time 12 F-35B Lightning II aircraft integrated into shipboard operations. Prior to this demo, the most F-35Bs on a ship at one time was 6. During the Lightning Carrier proof-of-concept demo, the ship's crew moved the Stovall aircraft around the deck to establish a suitable tempo of operations. It was an exciting end to the third and final at-sea developmental test phase for the Marine Corps variant.
Now we have a stealth capability off a relatively moderately sized ship, you know, less than 50,000 tons, that can be anywhere in the world, which means there's nowhere in the world that an enemy can hide. If we have the ability to send an amphibious ship there with F-35, then we can prosecute targets.
In August, the F-35C Lightning II carrier variant completed its third and final at-sea developmental test aboard USS George Washington. The goal was to test the aircraft's carrier suitability in adverse sea conditions. Naval aircraft undergo 3 developmental test phases at sea ahead of their scheduled initial operating capability. The V-22 Osprey is another step closer to assuming its future role in the carrier air wing. The Navy conducted a fleet battle experiment aboard the Carl Vinson to evaluate how the tilt rotor plane would perform as a carrier onboard delivery aircraft. Set to replace the Navy's C-2A Greyhound, the V-22 can land and take off vertically on the flight deck, eliminating the need to arrest and recover the COD aircraft. Its ability to operate like a helicopter on and off the ship will enable faster cargo deliveries and reduce the manpower burden for the ship. The Navy is developing its own version of the Osprey, the CMV-22 Bravo, with an extended-range fuel tank and long-range communications. It is set to procure the first of its V-22s in fiscal year 2018, with initial operational capability scheduled for FY21. The MQ4C Triton rounded out the year with its 100th flight from Naval Air Station Patuxent River. The aircraft flew over the newly commissioned USS Zumwalt in October as the ship traveled across the Chesapeake Bay. Days before, the program received Milestone C approval from the Department of the Navy, clearing the way for low-rate initial production, the first step of the production and deployment phase. When fully operational, Triton will provide 24/7 intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance for the U.S. Navy's surface ships. Also this year, the Triton Unmanned Patrol Squadron, VUP-19, located at Naval Air Station Jacksonville, Florida, welcomed its first commanding officer, indicating a transition from a pre-establishment unit to an operational squadron. Triton is scheduled to deploy in 2018. The CH53K King Stallion is doing more of the heavy lifting for the Marine Corps. The helicopter successfully completed its 2-week initial operational test period in October at the Sikorsky Developmental Flight Center in West Palm Beach, Florida. During the test, the CH-53K performed well, meeting all test objectives, including multiple external heavy weight lift scenarios. This was an important milestone because this was the first time an operational test has been done utilizing an all-Marine crew. The King Stallion is well on its way to achieving Milestone C and entering production. The aircraft is set to replace its predecessor, the CH-53E. Navair continues to play a major role in fueling the green fleet of the future. For the first time in history, a Navy aircraft, the EA18G Growler, completed flight testing of a 100% advanced biofuel at Naval Air Station Patuxent River, Maryland. The ability to incorporate alternative fuels into operational supplies will enable mission capability and flexibility in the future. The fuels program supports SECNAV's operational energy goal to increase the use of alternative fuels afloat by 2020. Fuel wasn't the only area Navair explored to find alternative solutions to meet fleet needs. The command made great strides in the area of additive manufacturing, a process that uses digital 3D design data to build components in layers of metal, plastic, and other materials. In July, an MV22B Osprey completed a successful flight demonstration of a flight-critical aircraft component built using additive manufacturing techniques. In this case, the 3D printed part was made from titanium. It is one of four link and fitting assemblies that attach the engine cell to the wing. The demonstration was a major step in understanding how 3D technology will benefit the fleet in the future.
If you look at our readiness posture and you look at what we need to do to accelerate, we need to improve not only how we get our airplanes back to the fleet and how we sustain them right now, but we need new capabilities out there faster. And additive is a technology that enables that.
Naval Aviation has explored additive manufacturing technology since the early 1990s, but this was the first time for a flight-critical application. This year, the Navair Commander challenged the workforce to find creative solutions to speed products to the fleet. A great example of this effort is the Solid Fuel Ramjet team in China Lake, California. The team had 6 months to take a technology from concept to test and fly a solid fuel ramjet on a weapon. Fueled by a tight budget and compressed time schedule, the team cut out unnecessary processes and, with the support of leadership, accepted risks that really paid off.
They were given a challenge to try something innovative, to get a new capability to the fleet that we think is going to be very, very valuable. They went out and moved very quickly, and they failed the first time. And we said, hey, that's okay. You think you know what went wrong? Get up, let's try it again. And they succeeded the second time.
Chief of Naval Operations Admiral John Richardson had the opportunity to learn about the solid fuel ramjet project during a recent visit to China Lake. This was his first visit to the facility since he was appointed in 2015. 2016 brought new challenges for some of the youngest members of the Navair workforce. The command kicked off the year with the second annual Innovation Challenge, a competition that tasked teams from across the organization to find a creative solution to a fleet need. Teams had 6 months and $25,000 to take an idea from paper to prototype. Dozens of teams submitted an idea. Leadership then narrowed the field to three teams from the aircraft division and two from weapons division. Participants learned to navigate the acquisition process and work with diverse teams to provide solutions in the areas of aircraft arrestments, power harvesting, hearing protection, situational awareness, and multi-sensor data filtering.
The teams in 6 months did amazing things that everyone was amazed. Reaching out beyond Navair's borders, working with industry, those kind of things, within 6 months is quite astounding. And I'm sure it proves that you can do these things if you allow yourself the freedom to innovate.
In March, the data community issued its own challenge. 33 teams from across the organization took part in the first data challenge, a 9-month competition that required teams to use data sources to improve aircraft readiness. Team Dino from Cherry Point was selected as the winner. Their project used predictive modeling and root cause analysis methods to improve Vector, a web-based tool used to identify aircraft parts affecting readiness.
Traditionally, we've been reactive, and we wait, and then we react to challenges that the fleet tells us about. We're now moving to where we can predict with our tools like Vector or CBM Plus, which is condition-based maintenance. We're now able to be predictive in when things are going to happen and proactively make changes so we can affect things before they really occur. And I think that's kind of huge. And over the past year, we've added collectively 68 aircraft across Naval Aviation back into a ready basic aircraft flying status that they wouldn't have otherwise been. Our vision is a globally deployed, mission-ready force. And so mission readiness is kind of key to that.
If you are interested in learning more about innovation opportunities across the organization, visit our website at www.navair.navy.mil/news. And that's it for this 2016 Year in Review edition of AIRWaves. See you on the flight line.